Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today in this video I am going to show you how to install the latest version of SQL Server on a Windows operating system, and after that I am also going to install SSMS, so which means SQL Server Management Studio. So that SQL Server Management Studio will give you a graphic user interface, so there you can easily create your database, you can easily create your table, insert data, fetch data, all that. So all that I am going to show you on this video. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee you will be learning a lot of new things, and if you are facing any issues in middle, you can always comment in our comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. Now to install SSMS, first you need to go to your favorite browser and to just simply search over here SQL Server download and hit enter, and you'll be seeing this SQL Server download Microsoft. So just simply click on that link and it's going to redirect to the official site of Microsoft. You can see we are in the official site of Microsoft. So this link I'm going to put right in your description, so you can just simply scroll down now and you'll be seeing that we have these two options. One is developer, another is the express one. So I'm going to recommend you to install the express one. So just simply click on the download button and you can see our file is downloaded over here, installer file. All right, so just simply click on open file to install it locally on our system. So it will ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes, and there you go. You can see our SQL Server Express Edition is rightly opened over here. So here it is asking which type of installation type you want to do. I'm going to show you a basic installation. So just simply click on basic, and you can see that now it is showing the license agreement. So you can always read this and then click on accept. And this is where our SQL Server Management Studio is going to be installed. So just simply click on install, and you can see it is properly started fetching all the files from internet and going to install it locally on your system, right? So this thing will take some time, you need to have active internet connection, right? Right throughout this installation, so it will take time. You can grab some coffee or tea, whatever you like, and you can again come back. All right, so I'm also going to do the same. Yep. So welcome back, and now you can clearly see that our SQL Server Express Edition is installed successfully. So you can see our connection string, then our server installer log folder, then media folder, then resources folder, all of that, right? So now that our SQL Server is rightly installed, it's time to install our SSMS, right? So just simply click on this install SSMS, and it's going to redirect to the official site of Microsoft. So here you need to just simply scroll down and you will be able to see this free download for SQL Server Management Studio called SSMS. So just simply click on that link and immediately you'll be seeing our setup is rightly started downloading. So let's wait for a minute, and you can see that our SSMS is rightly downloaded over here. So just simply click on open file, and let's minimize our browser. So you can see it is rightly open. So first, close our SQL Server. Yes. So now we have only SQL Server Management Studio. So this is where our SQL Server Management Studio is going to be installed. Just simply click on install, and it will ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes, and there you go. You can see it is rightly started installing. So this installing SSMS will take some time, about 5 minutes or so. So give some time. So once we are done installing SSMS, I'm going to again back to this video. Yep. So welcome back. So now we can clearly see that our Microsoft SQL Server Management Studio is rightly installed. So you can see that setup is completed now. So you can just simply close. So now that you know that both our SQL Server Management Studio and our SQL Server are installed, it's time to do some code. So just simply go to search and just simply type over here SSMS. You'll be seeing this SQL Server Management Studio 19 under app. So you need to click on that SSMS, and you can see it is rightly launched. So this is the interface of our SSMS. So you can see that it is using Windows authentication. So if you need a video about SQL Server authentication, then please put a comment in your comment sections. I'll surely going to make a video about SQL Server authentication. So in this video I'm going to use Windows authentication. So I'm just going to click on connect, and you can see it is rightly started connecting, and here it is rightly connected over here. So if you simply click on this expand icon of our database, you can see you have system database, then database snapshots. So if you expand system databases, you can see we have MasterDB, then ModelDB, then MSDB, and we have a TempDB. So these are all system databases, right? But now I'll show you how we can create a new DB. So for that, you need to click on this new query and it will open a new query window. So here, let's create a database. So create a database, you know, demo. And I'm going to end with semicolon and I'm going to click on execute, and immediately you can see our command is successfully executed. So let's create a table. So create a table emp, and within the emp we have couple of, you know, columns. So one is id, so id will be of integer type, and then we have a name field, and name field will be of a varchar type, and it will be of 50. All right, so just simply end with semicolon, select, you know, our query and click on execute, and you can see our command is executed successfully. So let's, you know, insert a couple of values. So insert into emp, then we have our, then we have, you know, a couple of columns, so which is id comma name, and then we are going to put values. And then let's give the ID as 1, and I'm going to, you know, name, give the name as Rahul. So after, you know, end with a semicolon, you need to select this and click on execute, and you can see our command is successfully executed. And now if you just simply do select star from emp, just end with semicolon, and if you select this and click on execute, immediately can see that it is properly fetched that ID 1 and name Rahul on our result window, right? So in this way you can easily install SQL Server in the Windows operating system. And after that, I have also showed you how to create database, how to create table, how to insert some data within our table, how to fetch all of that on this video. So if these videos are really helping you, please do like, share and subscribe, and you can let me know about that within our comment sections, so that will really motivate me to make more such videos. And also don't forget to subscribe our channel. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.